Hi, I'm Kate Harrison. I'm a Board Certified Behavior Analyst with Brett DiNovi & Associates. In this video, we're going to be touching on sections A04 and FK47 of the fourth edition BACB task list. In behavior analysis, we've developed a wide range of methods to identify, modify, and measure behavior change in a meaningful way. Bloom and colleagues call measurement the process of applying qualitative or quantitative labels to events, phenomena, or observed properties using a standard set of conscious-based rules by which to apply labels to those occurrences. In other words, measurement is a tool that gives consumers a common way to describe and compare behavior with a set of labels that convey a common meaning. Let's face it, without measurement, we really wouldn't be able to do our jobs, and we wouldn't be able to do it well. We measure behavior to ensure we're making productive changes in the lives of the people that we serve. In this video, we're specifically going to be discussing a type of measurement called response latency. Let's first review the three ways we can measure behavior, also known as the measurable dimensions of behavior. One, repeatability. This refers to a behavior that can be counted. Two, temporal locus. This refers to when in time a behavior occurs in relation to events of interest. And three, temporal extent. This refers to a behavior's duration or how long it's occurring for. Response latency is a measure of temporal locus. Latency, by definition, is a measure of the elapsed time between the onset of a stimulus, like an instruction, cue, or signal, and the initiation of a subsequent response. If a practitioner is concerned with the amount of time it takes for a learner to initiate a behavior after the relevant discriminative stimulus has occurred, latency would be the way to measure that. You may have experience working with a learner who has a goal to decrease response latency, say the time it takes to initiate getting out of her seat when the teacher says line up, or perhaps you've targeted increasing response latency in a learner who frequently engages in incorrect responses or problem behavior without giving themselves enough time to consider the problem or alternative options for behavior. Or maybe you're like me and you've had a real life situation where latency has been applied. When I first moved from Virginia to New York City, I learned very quickly that my response latency from the discriminative stimulus of a stoplight turning green to my response of putting my foot on the gas pedal was far too long for my new city standards. To record response latency, you'll need to, one, identify a clear discriminative stimulus, two, ensure that the target behavior has a distinct starting point so that you know exactly when it begins. Three, grab your watch or timer and start the clock upon the discriminative stimulus and stop it upon the initiation of the target behavior. Four, have a data sheet available to record the response latency time that you collected. Latency data is typically displayed by using range, median, or mean. The mean is the average of the total sum of time. The median is the duration lying in the middle of the full range of various times. And the range is the variation between the lower and upper limits of the recorded times. Response latency can be socially significant in the lives of many of the individuals that we serve. So it's necessary as behavior analysts that we be comfortable and fluent in this form of measurement. Latency research has been conducted in applications involving functional analyses of elopement, like Traub and Vollmer's 2019 study, as well as to decrease academic response time in adolescents, like the 2013 study by Heinecke and colleagues. Let's hear from you. What are some situations in which latency measurement would be socially significant in your life? Perhaps you're trying to decrease the time it takes for you to get out of bed after your alarm goes off, or maybe you are trying to increase your latency in responding to an email so that you can get a little bit of extra time to have a more thoughtful response. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and if you would like to help us spread the science, please consider sharing this video and subscribing to our channel. Thanks.